Hey guys, this is Typhorus Reacts, and I'm back to react to Fairy Tale episode 284, Memoirs. So, yeah, okay, I'll just get the video started real quick. And, if it'll load, please, thank you. Alright, come on. If it'll load, please. Okay, here we go. Okay, so, okay, it buffered for a second, but whatever. Okay, so, ooh, hey, Zerif. So,
it's almost unthinkable. Yes, these ideas. You wrote this treatise yourself.
Yes!
I see. The work is quite impressive, but I cannot condone the content. It's not appropriate for a child to discuss matters such as these. Your age notwithstanding, magic pertaining to life and death is dangerous and forbidden territory.
Mm.
You must not delve further into it. It would surely be looked upon as an act of hubris. Such thinking would risk drawing the ire of the god of life and death on Xen. Thus, we will not allow you to continue pursuing this matter. Well, Zerif, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
And then he pursued it. Yeah, once the intro starts, I'll do a recap. And back to the present. Okay, so, last time, I guess this technically wraps up the Avatar arc, unless, you know, Fairy Tail getting back together counts as still part of the Avatar arc. But, so, last time, many members of Fairy Tail have reunited. We got Natsu, Lucy, Urza, Gray, Happy, Juvia, Wendy, Carla, and, I believe that's it other than, Gajiel, Levy, and Panther Lily, so, I guess it makes 11, so, or maybe, yeah, I think that's 11, so, I don't know, maybe I miscounted, now a lot of them are now back together, and I guess now is going to be the time when Fairy Tail gets back together as an entirety. And and I suppose this episode we're going to be looking more into Zerif and his whole deal, and then, you know, yeah, like I said before, Fairy Tail getting back together as a whole, you know, every member coming back and all that. So, all right, and the intro's done. Here we go.
Must have been a dream. Can't remember the last time I had one.
Hmm.
Not soon. It's been ages since my younger brother was with us. At the time he was taken.
Hmm. All right, Memoirs. Yeah, that was right. We're just looking into more, you know, Zerif's past and backstory. And the stuff he was looking up wasn't exactly humane, as much as he tried to make it, at least. He tried to. All he wanted was his brother back, really. Hmm.
There's still much work to be done.
must I repeat myself, Zerith? The type of magic that you're exploring is strictly forbidden. Have you not considered the toll? The sheer number of lives that must be sacrificed for your design to work? Life and death are both bound by nature. And they fall under the rules of gods, not mere mortals.
Consider life. There exists an element of human choice in its creation, does there not? So then, why should death be fully exempt from that?
Aunt Selim, I beseech you to have mercy on this boy's soul. Despite our repeated warnings over the years, you remain obsessed with the dangerous idea of reviving the dead. And because of this, the board has decided to expel you. This was not an easy decision. We all had such high hopes for you.
Not now, please, sir.
Your brother is never coming back. And nothing you can do will change that.
And here we go. A curse of contradiction. Contradiction. He killed everyone accidentally.
Before I knew it, the lives of every teacher and student at the academy had been snuffed out.
Really? Buffering? Okay. Come on, what the heck? Just a second, guys. And just when I thought my Wi-Fi troubles were over for the day, the internet cut out. So, yeah, it doesn't usually do this late in the day, so I had no reason to worry. But whatever. I guess we're back. We're at 8 minutes and 29 seconds, so let's go. Yeah, the curse of contradiction is a pretty scary thing once you really start thinking about it.
This curse also stops my process of aging, dooming me to live forever.
Mm-hmm.
After the school, I was plagued by conflict, unfathomable guilt for taking so many lives. Yet the fact that I could continue my studies forever pleased me greatly.
Mm-hmm.
And in turn, that joy disgusted me.
Mm.
After wandering through that existential labyrinth of years, I came to a conclusion. My death will bring all this to an end. So I began to undertake the most taboo magic of all. That which which creates life.
I mean, what are they going to do? Curse him with contradiction twice? Yep.
Eventually, I created my magnum opus that could bring all this to an end.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I called it END. Aetherius, Natsu, Dragneel.
Mm-hmm.
But this was not some...
Buffered out for a second, but whatever.
...used as a means to an end. She was human from the beginning. Flesh and blood. I had cared for my beloved brother's body all those years.
Indeed, they will.
Can I even call him a man?
The other big bad.
I can assume this is how you normally look. How's your arm healing now? Well, Acnologia, Black Wizard, what is it you want? You crave destruction, yet you hardly indulge yourself. If you so desired, you could use your power to bring the entire world to its knees. But for some reason you haven't. Whether it's a matter of principle or ambition is unclear. The same could be said of you. To be quite honest, my indecision is what has kept me out of the fray.
I still can't get over the fact that Acnologia is voiced by J. Michael Tatum. It's great.
Or would the opposite better suit my needs? But I've come to the conclusion that the question itself is flawed. After weighing my interests, I am on neither side. Both you and mankind should be wiped out. What do you think? You have been waiting for a serious challenge, correct? I am the one who will bring that to you. The world will be a human, a dragon, and an immortal will constitute this final battle.
Good old transitions.
In my opinion, Magnolia is the jewel of Eastern Peori. It had shone much brighter when the fairy tale guild hall was part of the skyline. Strange to think it's been a year since we walked these streets.
Does this bring back some memories or what?
Hey, look! They fixed up Cardia Cathedral! The members we've been able to find were all in favor of getting the guild back together. It's so good to see everything's back to normal. The town's always been resilient. Yeah. After the fight with Avatar, our group needed to split up for a while. But we agreed
again
to here at Magnolia.
Yeah, there we are.
Too long, but I need to report back to Jalal first.
Hey, gosh. Can you not tell the council about us? Keep it hush-hush.
They wouldn't approve of us shacking up.
Give me a break. I mean, me and others.
Leave poor innocent Wendy's ears alone.
The council was my true calling. That is supposed to be a joke, right? I bet old Woodface will be sad to see me go.
Well, that one's definitely a joke.
I'm sure I'll rescue.
about Xerath from those Avatar members. They worshipped him, but they didn't actually know him.
Yeah.
Is something wrong? You look sad. Aren't you glad to be back here? Of course I am. I just kind of got lost in my memories for a second. Yeah. So many memories were made in this town. Some are sad. Some are happy. Most of them still make me smile. I formed them with my fairy tale family. I was afraid after what happened last year.
Master, are you out of your mind? What's wrong with you? I can't believe you wouldn't talk to us first. How will we put food on the table?
Yeah, we need money.
Tell us you're joking.
I am disbanding the Fairy Tale Guild, which means from this point on, you must forge your own way forward. That's fine.
I just can't accept this, Master. You gotta realize that you're messing with our lives here.
I nearly forgot that the guild hall was destroyed again at the beginning of like the Tartarus arc. That's why I was a bit confused. I was a bit confused about the crater for a second. I was like, oh wait. Judging by the other best girl behind you. Yo, Kana. Oh yeah, she's a bit drunk. Same old Kana. Never change, Kana. I swear, like, I can't decide who's best girl, Urza or Kana. I love them both. There they are. I mean, yeah, it's what he does. Yo, everyone. I'm guessing Nab still hasn't been able to pick a job. Yo, the Strauss siblings.
A reunion fit for a real man.
Yeah. There's Mira. Mira may be voiced by the worst voice actress, but it's still good to see her character. Oh, whoops. Probably shouldn't do that while leaning on the table. There it is. The flag. Alright, I guess that ends the episode. And now to edit these two videos together just to get this reaction out, and then I'm gonna have to then stay tuned for later on today when I go to episode, I believe, 285, which is the Seventh Guildmaster. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and yeah, I got another little say, just, yeah, it's interesting to see, Xerath's backstory, and then finally the return of all, you know, just all of Fairy Tail. So, yeah, even Vegeta showed up. I didn't actually recognize him at first. You usually see him in, like, a skin-tight suit just dancing on top of a table. So, yeah. Yeah, I got nothing else to say, so I'm just gonna end the video here. So yeah, till next time, guys. See ya.